So we were discussing about the thermodynamic diagrams, and yesterday we discussed in detail about the Tifigram. Okay, the various features of Tifigram we discussed yesterday. Today we shall talk about the basis of these thermodynamic diagrams. Okay, what are the basis and how many types of thermodynamic diagrams are there? Although we discussed the Tifigram in detail, that is because that is the one which is very popular. Also, yesterday I was just talking about the Beaufort wind scale, right? Has any one of you tried to find out what is this Beaufort wind scale? Anybody? No? Yes or no?
No, sir. No, sir.
No, none. Not yet. Okay. So let me quickly tell you about this Beaufort wind scale. This is the Beaufort wind scale table. Is this table clear to you? Clearly visible to you? All of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Well, this table was actually designed by Sir Francis Beaufort, and I was telling you, in the old days, you know, when there was no anemometer, people used to estimate the wind speed based upon the damages it used to cause. Okay, and this Beaufort scale was designed by the scientist called Beaufort in, I think, around 1800 AD, or almost 200 years ago. Okay, as you can see from this scale, scale ranging from 0 to 12, okay, and for various wind speeds, you know, one can see when the wind is calm or when you see the smokes rise vertically, that means wind is calm and the wind speed is less than 1 kilometer per hour. This is kilometer per hour, this is miles per hour, and this is in knots, okay, unit. When the wind motion is visible in the smoke, suppose when you can see the smoke wavering, that means some light wind is there. So there is light here. And wind speed in that case is supposed to be 1 to 5 kilometer per hour. When wind felt on exposed skin, leaves rustle, that means light breeze, wind speed could be 6 to 11 kilometer per hour. And so on. You know, various descriptions are there. Like when leaves and small twigs in constant motion, dust and loose paper are raised, small branches begin to move, wind speed could be 20 to 28 kilometer per hour. Small trees begin to sway, that means it is about 29 to 38 kilometer per hour. Light branches are in motion. Whistling is heard in overhead wires. Umbrella use is difficult. So the wind speed could be 39 to 49 kilometer per hour. Old trees in motion, some difficulty experienced walking into the wind, that means 50 to 60, 61 kilometer per hour. Twigs and small branches break from trees, cars veer on road, that means strong wind speed, 62 to 74 kilometer per hour. Larger branches break from trees, light structural damage, that means speed is 75 to 88 kilometer per hour. Trees are broken and uprooted, considerable structural damage to the houses, for example. That means wind speed is 89 to 102 kilometer per hour. Widespread damage to structures and vegetation, 103 to 117 kilometer per hour. And considerable and widespread damage to structures and vegetation. Violence, that means more than 117 kilometer per hour. Well, these things are possible only when there is a tornado. Otherwise, for these things, you know, even severe thunderstorms or severe nor'westers can cause up to this much very easily. Okay, so this is the classical Beaufort scale. When you have no instrument with you, you can still estimate how much could be the wind speed by looking at the surroundings or the damages caused, you know, because of this strong wind. All right. So this is what I was trying to tell you yesterday. Now let's come back to the thermodynamic diagram, which we were discussing earlier. Okay. So Is this slide clear? Am I audible and visible clearly?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So thermodynamic diagrams, already by now you know the introduction of it. Okay. The thermodynamic diagram provides graphical display of the lines representing major kinds of processes to which it may be subjected to, such as isobaric, isothermal, dry adiabatic, and pseudo adiabatic. A thermodynamic diagram has three important.
Excuse me, sir.
What? Yes.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, BG is trying to enter.
Who?
BG.
I see. Okay. I admit. Okay. Because our screen was covered by the PowerPoint, so I could not see. Now, so Vijit, are you there in? Vijit, yes, I can see you probably. And I see that Sangram, have you joined?
Yes, sir, I'm here, sir.
Can you
sir, I have a question, sir.
Today, sir. Can you see the video?
Sir, no. I have a question, sir.
What is the question? Can you switch on the video first of all?
Okay, sir. Sir, in earlier slide, there is something BFOUT number something. What does BFOUT number mean, sir?
That number indicates the scale of the BFOUT. Now, basically, it varies from 1 to 12, okay? But your interest is to find out what is the estimated wind speed, okay? Well, nowadays, okay, you know, those things are classical because nowadays you have got sophisticated instruments, all right?
Yes, sir.
To measure the wind, anemometer, and many other sources like sensors, etc. So people now don't use those skills. Only when now something has happened at a place where there is no instrument, like for example, suppose if there is a severe thunderstorm or some storm has come passed over a village, and there are so many structural damages, so many houses have collapsed, or trees are broken, and there is no instrument over there, then by looking at the damage, you can estimate the wind, of course, using the BFOUT scale. Okay. So, Kunal, can you just switch on the video? I haven't seen you yet. Yes. So, you have missed a lot of your classes, you know? Kunal? You have missed almost like 14, 15 classes, and we have covered a substantial part of the syllabus. Okay, now you have to be regular. Every day you must attend the class because now it is becoming serious. If you miss any more class, that means you will not be allowed for the examination, or maybe, you know, if you continuously miss, all your other students should know, if you are continuously absent for 15 days without any genuine reason, that means your admission also can get cancelled. All right, so you must be careful. Your mic is mute, Kunal. Your mic is mute. I can't hear you.
Sir, I was present in almost all classes from last 3 days. And sir, I'll be present for all the classes, sir.
Now onwards, you should be present. But you said you were present in last 3 classes, but I don't see you in the log. My log of attendance log. I have attendance log created automatically. And I can see that who came at what time and who left at what time. No.
Okay,
whether intentionally or because of the internet interruption. No. If you are logged out or if you are disconnected because of the internet, that also is recorded at what time you were disconnected. So in last 3 days also, you just came in and just vanished after that. Okay. So now you have to make sure that you don't miss any class. Right? And as I said, no, although I have been giving the video lectures of all the classes, but don't depend on the video lectures alone. Okay, that is just a supplement. And that supplement is given to help you because of this COVID situation, Corona situation. Since you are not able to come to the university campus, therefore the video lecture is provided to you to help you. But don't depend upon that completely. Presence in the class is very, very important because your attendance is counted. And also, you are interactive. In the class, you are interactive, right? Which you cannot be, while just watching the video, you cannot be interactive. Okay? So henceforth, don't miss any class, otherwise it will become serious for you. All right?
No, sir. I'll be present in all the classes, sir. Upcoming classes, sir.
Right. Okay. So, and all the lecture that you have missed, that you have to, of course, now cover up now by looking at the video and the PowerPoint, which I will be sending you with you later, now with all of you. So, that you have to do. Plus, I hope that you have got all the books downloaded. Have you got the syllabus of the book, of this course?
Yes, sir. I got the syllabus, sir.
Okay. And have you downloaded the books, the textbooks?
Sir, not yet, sir. But I'll download it, sir, later, sir.
Yeah.
Today,
so
sir.
You download the textbook. Most of them are available free on the internet.
Okay, sir.
And if you have any problem, you talk to your
okay,
classmates.
Sir. I'll definitely download it today, sir.
Yes. You download all the
classes. After the class, I'll download it, sir.
Yes. Exactly. All right?
All right,
so,
sir.
So, now we go back to the lecture.
Okay, sir.
Right, so we have been discussing about the thermodynamic diagrams, right? And as I said, the thermodynamic diagrams are used to display various characteristics or features of the atmosphere. Am I audible and visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, the diagram, thermodynamic diagram has three important characteristics. Okay. Number one, since energy changes are of primary importance, can somebody, and I think all of you should mute your mic when you are not talking. You better mute your mic, because otherwise there is a background noise. Right. So all of you mute your mic if you are not talking. You are not asking any questions.
Who is present in all the classes?
Okay. So when you are not asking any question, or when I am not asking you any question, then you mute your mic. Otherwise, noise. Okay.
It's Sangram, sir, his mic is unmute.
Sangram, you mute your mic.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. When I am not asking you any question, or when you are not asking any question, then your mic must be mute. Otherwise, there is a background noise. All right?
Sir, I forgot to
yeah.
mute, sir. Sorry, sir.
Okay, now you mute. Right. Okay, so as I said, since energy changes are of primary importance, the area enclosed by the lines representing any cyclic process be proportional to the change in energy of the work done during the process. This is one of the requirement of thermodynamic diagrams. Okay, the second requirement is that as many fundamental lines as possible be straight. Okay, yesterday we were discussing about the diaphragm, and we said that some of the lines are straight, but some of them are curved. But by choosing the x and y axis variables, we try to have the fundamental lines straight as much as possible. Okay. The third criteria is that the angle between the isotherms and the dry adiabats be as large as possible. Okay. This angle is considered to be good at 90 degrees. If they are perpendicular to each other, then they are supposed to be good. Okay. The fundamental definition of work, as you know, is dW is equal to P d alpha, where this is the work done, this is the pressure, P is the pressure, and alpha is the specific volume, the change in the specific volume. And this suggests that pressure and the specific volume be used as coordinates in order to satisfy the first criteria, that means this one. Okay. That means in the cyclic process, the energy be proportional. Whenever you are trying to project a diagram, a thermodynamic diagram in another form, then this criteria must be satisfied. Okay. Then, however, the angle between the isotherms in an alpha P diagram does not satisfy the third condition, that is the 90 degree condition. Right? Third condition requires that the isotherms and adiabate be perpendicular to each other as much as possible. But when we choose the alpha P diagram, that means alpha and P are the coordinates. Suppose P is the vertical, y-axis, and alpha is in the x-axis, then the third criteria is not satisfied. Okay, so that's why we try to choose different ways how we can satisfy now as much as possible all the three criteria of a thermodynamic diagram. We may seek the means of setting up other suitable diagrams with two thermodynamic variables. Now instead of alpha and p, we can try to choose different variables subject to the restriction that the new diagram shall be equal to the area influenced by the same cycle on alpha b diagram. Okay, such a diagram is called an equal area transformation of alpha b diagram. Okay, and we may examine these new diagrams to see how well they satisfy the other two criteria. Okay, so we'll examine one by one. Now let's consider two variables A and B, each being a function of one or more thermodynamic variables. Okay, now since a thermodynamic variable is determined by the state of the system, it suffices to know alpha and p for a person to determine A and B. In other words, if you know the pressure and volume of an air parcel, that means you know fairly good about the characteristics of the parcel. Okay. So now see this figure, for example. Now you have this classical p alpha diagram. P on the y-axis, alpha on the x-axis. This is the volume, specific volume, and this is the pressure decreasing upward or increasing downward. Okay. And you are describing thermodynamic state of a system by this closed circle. Now, when you are trying to project this diagram onto another form of a diagram, so let us say in which your y-axis is represented by A and x-axis is represented by B, then this diagram must be able to project this cyclic process in such a way that area enclosed by this circle is equal to the area enclosed by that circle. Okay, then only it will be a perfect transformation of the diagram. All right. This diagram is representation of a cyclic cycle on alpha b diagram and its equal area transformation to a b diagram. Okay. Thus, each point on alpha b diagram corresponds to a point on the a b diagram. And any closed cycle on one is a closed cycle, perhaps of different shape, although the shape may be different. Now they are not exactly the same, but the area enclosed by this circle must be equal to the area enclosed by this shape. Okay, it is always required that the area enclosed on one diagram be equal to the area enclosed on the other. Thus, for any given cyclic process, can write closed integration of p d alpha is equal to closed integration of a d b. Okay, then only this condition will be satisfied. Then only the area enclosed by this shape will be equal to the area enclosed by this shape. What you are trying to write mathematically. Okay, you're trying to write that, state that mathematically. Or you can write closed integral of p d alpha plus a d b is equal to zero, what it implies. Okay, but for this closed lines integral to be zero, the integrand must be an exact differential such as ds, let us say. That means p d alpha plus a d b must be equal to ds, where ds is a exact differential. Okay, let's say exact differential, then only the closed integral of that will be zero. Consider S as a function of alpha and B. Okay, alpha, where alpha is the volume, specific volume. Then we can write ds of alpha B, because S is a function of alpha and B, is equal to del S by del alpha B at constant B d alpha plus del S by del B at constant alpha dB. Right, just differentiating. Okay, or expanding this differential. Therefore, sufficient conditions for an equal area transformation are P is equal to this one, del S by del alpha of B, and A is equal to del S by del B of alpha, right? This is what we are trying to say, that on the y-axis we have pressure as one of the variable, right? And which we have just transformed to A in another diagram, A, okay, on the y-axis, all right? So if we now differentiate the first term, partially this term, with respect to B, and the second term with respect to alpha, okay, then we can write del P by del B at constant alpha is equal to del square S divided by del alpha del B, and del A by del alpha at constant B is equal to del square S divided by del square del alpha of del B. Okay, therefore, if del A by del alpha at constant B is equal to del P by del B at constant alpha, let's say this is equation number one. Areas will be equal on the two diagrams that you saw earlier in the previous slide. Okay, so if we know, if we now specify the nature of the thermodynamic variable B, it is possible to determine what A must be in order to have an equal area transformation from alpha P to AB. Okay, this is what we have to have for equal area transformation. First, in this category or in this series of thermodynamic diagram is called the imagram. Imagram, also short form of energy transformation diagram. Okay, imagram. We discussed earlier, yesterday for us today, in detail about the trifigram. Okay, that is more advanced version of this thermodynamic diagrams, and that's what is used most popularly. But the first in this series was called the, is called the imagram. Now consider the case when B is equal to T, that means your x-axis is equal to temperature. This is a logical choice for one of the coordinates of a diagram, since one of the atmospheric properties we measure is the temperature. Okay, so from equation one, that is the first equation you saw in the last slide, you can write del A by del alpha at constant temperature, T is equal to del P by del T at constant alpha. This is what we have seen, the criteria for equal area transformation. The right side can be evaluated from the equation of a state, that is P alpha is equal to RT. This is the equation of a state. Okay, so by substituting from the equation of a state in this term, we find that we can get del A by del alpha at constant temperature is equal to R divided by alpha. Okay, by just substituting from the equation of the state. Or you can write del A by del alpha at constant temperature, D alpha is equal to R D alpha divided by alpha. Okay, from this one, simply multiply both sides by D alpha. So upon integration of this equation, we can get A is equal to R log alpha plus a function of T, Ft. Okay, let's say this is equation number two. Here, instead of a constant of integration, okay, one obtains an unspecified function of temperature, T. Since the integral requires T to be constant, okay, so just like constant of integration, F is at our disposal. In other words, we can adjust this term so that this equation gets closed or valid. Now let us take logarithm of equation of a state, which is this one. Take a logarithm of this equation of a state, P alpha equal to RT. And we can write log of alpha is equal to minus of log of P plus log of R plus log of T. Okay, by taking the logarithm of the equation of a state. Substituting this into this equation number two, we can get A is equal to minus R log P plus in bracket R log R plus R log T plus Ft, okay, function of T. We shall choose Ft such that the terms in the bracket, okay, cancel completely. I mean, because these are at our disposal. So we are free to do this since these terms consist of constants and functions of temperature only. Okay, R is constant here, and the entire term in the bracket is a function of temperature only. Okay. So one can choose the function of temperature for which the terms in the bracket reduces to zero. Thus, we can write A is equal to minus R of log P by choosing in such a way that this entire term is zero. So it becomes A is equal to minus R log P, and as we have said, we have chosen B is equal to T. That means now on your y-axis, instead of taking simple pressure, you are taking minus R of log P, and on the x-axis, you are taking the temperature as your variable. Okay, so this is one type of transformation. And when we do that, then we can represent the diagram in this form. Okay, now here, this is your pressure. Okay, this is your temperature. And as you recall, similar to the diagram, these lines are the lines of equal potential temperature. That means they are the adiabates, right? Dry adiabates. They are all straight. Okay, they are all straight lines, but inclined. And then you have got a slightly curved line, dashed line here. If you recall, the diagram, this was the moist adiabate. And also, you have got another line for the mixing ratio. Okay, so this type of diagram obtained by selecting the y-axis to be minus R log P and the x-axis to be T, you get this kind of diagram, and which is called the imagram. It's called the imagram. Okay, note that now there are some slight variations between different diagrams. Like imagram is not exactly same as the diagram. Okay, and there are other diagrams also, like a STB diagram, skip T log P diagram, and so on. Okay, we shall discuss about these things also today. Now, a person called, scientist called Rapsdal, named it as energy per unit mass diagram, or simply imagram. Okay, imagram basically implies energy per unit mass diagram. Okay, imagram. Imagram consists of a linear scale of temperature and logarithmic scale of pressure, because this is R log P. So pressure is logarithmic basically. As in the atmosphere, thus isobars and isotherms are straight. These are the isobars and these are the isotherms. Okay, they are straight and perpendicular to each other. Isobars, isotherms, and dry adiabates, they are inclined, straight lines, dry adiabates. Okay, saturation mixing ratio line, saturation mixing ratio line. Okay, this one, and this pseudo adiabate, this one, this is pseudo adiabate. Okay, on an imagram are shown here in this diagram. Okay, since pressure is on a log scale, the line P is equal to zero is at the infinity. That means you can have a very deep atmosphere. No, as much as you want. The diagram is terminated at some conveniently low pressure. Generally, I mean, it can be up to 100 millibar also, but here it is written for 100 millibar. Okay, generally, you know, we go up to tropopause, generally, because observations are available mostly up to tropopause, also sometimes in the stratosphere. But the tropopause height varies from place to place. In our case, in our tropical latitude in tropics, tropopause can be 15 to 16 kilometers off the ground. But in the mid latitude, it can be maybe about 10, 12 kilometers. And that's why maybe it's up to 400 millibar. If you go further north or south to the, toward the pole, then the tropopause height is further low. Okay. The distance between the isobars 800 and 400 millibar is proportional to log of 800 minus log of 400 is log of 2. And the separation between 400 and 200 millibar is again equal to log of 400 minus log of 200 is equal to log of 2. Thus, each isobar can be re-leveled with any fraction of its original value. Okay, on the imagram. The shape of the dry adiabate on an imagram can be deduced by taking the log of Poisson's equation. Poisson's equation is, remember, we discussed what the Poisson's equation. That is the equation for the potential temperature. Okay, theta. Considering theta to be constant, we can determine the shape of the dry adiabate on the imagram. And we can write that minus of log P is equal to minus of 1 over k log T plus constant. okay, where K is the R by Cp. If you recall in the definition of the potential temperature, okay. So the area by the isotherm angle can be changed by varying one or the other of the coordinate scales. However, convenience of use and economy of paper limits one freedom here. In practice, the angle between adiabates and isotherms on an imagram is nearly 45 degrees. Okay, as you have seen in the previous diagram, this is appreciably better than the corresponding angle on an alpha p diagram. Okay, so we are trying to represent the state of the variables in a better and better way now compared to simple alpha p diagram, right? Classical diagram. In summary, the imagram has number one, area proportional to energy; number two, four sides of lines which are exactly or nearly straight, and one side which is curved. Okay, and the third characteristic is adequately good angle between adiabates and isotherms, and therefore it is a convenient diagram which is in wide use. Okay, well, diagram is the widest one. So basically, that means all the three criteria now required for the transformation of the diagram, as we discussed earlier, is fulfilled here, okay, in the imagram. Now let's discuss the basis of the diagram that you already seen. Okay, the diagram. What is the basis for this? Now this diagram may be developed by letting B is equal to T. As for the imagram, that means on your x-axis you are choosing the temperature as the variable. Okay, as you have seen on the diagram, temperature is on the x-axis. Thus, A is equal to R of log alpha plus F of T. Okay, that means on the y-axis, that means this is one. As before, but this time instead of substituting from the equation of a state, let us introduce the potential temperature from the Poisson's equation. Okay, earlier if you recall, while discussing the imagram, we tried to substitute from the equation of a state. Okay, now instead of substituting from the equation of a state, we are now substituting from the Poisson's equation, which is the definition of the potential temperature. Okay, and if we do that, we can write from the Poisson's equation or from the definition of the potential temperature, T by theta is equal to P divided by 1000 power K kappa, okay, which is equal to RT divided by 1000 times alpha to the power kappa, okay, where alpha is the specific volume. Okay, we have substituted this from the equation of state, P equal to RT by alpha. Okay, and you must remember the definition of the potential temperature as we discussed earlier. By taking the logarithm and solving for log of alpha, we can get log of alpha is equal to 1 over kappa log theta minus log T plus log T plus log R minus log of 1000. Okay, this is what we can get by taking the logarithm. Or we can write R of log alpha is equal to Cp log theta plus a function of G. G is a function of temperature. Okay, so now this we can substitute R log of alpha here. Okay, when the function gt includes the constants 1000 and r, okay, rest of all the rest of the terms is included in this function. Okay, we have just solved this equation for r log alpha, okay, which is equal to cp log theta plus rest of the terms are included in this function. Okay, so we can write now this a is equal to cp log theta from here plus Ft plus Gt. Okay, this time we shall choose the arbitrary function Ft is equal to minus Gt, so that the coordinates become A is equal to Cp log theta and B is equal to T. Okay, A is equal to Cp log theta and B is equal to T. So now see the difference between the imagram and the diagram. Now the coordinates have changed. Okay, now here and the y-axis you have got Cp log theta. Okay, earlier you had R log P, minus of R log P, but now you have got Cp log theta, and x-axis is the same, okay, temperature as in the imagram. since Cp log theta is equal to entropy, recall the definition of entropy, right? We have discussed earlier, and also you have studied in your BSc entropy. So entropy is equal to Cp log theta. Okay. Apart from an additive constant, Sir Napier saw, the name of the scientist who introduced this diagram, call it the T phi gram or Tephigram. Okay, T phi diagram or Tephigram. Okay, so a diagram in which the y-axis or ordinate is represented by Cp log theta, and abscissa, the x-axis, is represented by the temperature, is called the T phi gram or simply Tephigram. Okay. The equation of isobars on a diphigram, Tephigram, may be obtained by taking the logarithm of the Poisson's equation. For a constant value of pressure P, write theta equals log of P plus constant. Since one coordinate of this diagram is log of theta, but the other is a linear scale of T, the isobars are logarithmic curves which slope upward to the right and decrease in slope with increasing temperature. Okay, as you have seen in the diagram, and it is again shown here in this diagram. Okay, so this side is your, this side is what? Pressure, logarithmic of pressure, this is logarithmic scale. Okay, this side is temperature. Okay, so all these lines are familiar to you, but slightly the orientations are different compared to the imagram. You can recall, or you can see later on in the books also. Most of the lines are same, but the orientation is different. Now theta, that means dry derivatives are like this one. Okay, you are the theta. You can just change the orientation also of the diagram. The diphigram that you have seen yesterday or day for yesterday in the class, basically is the same one shown here, but slightly changed in the orientation. And all the lines you can now recognize clearly. Now these lines are the isobars. Okay, these lines are the adiabates, that means equal potential temperature lines. These are the isotherms. These are the isotherms. Okay, this is the pseudo adiabate or moist adiabate, and the mixing ratio line. Okay, so you can see here also the isotherms and the adiabates are almost perpendicular to each other, 90 degree to each other. So this fulfills one of the criteria, okay, of the thermodynamic diagram. So the isobars have one gentle curvature and are nearly straight. Okay, gentle curvature. You can see it is not exactly horizontal, but very gentle, slight curvature is there, but nearly straight. It is possible to rotate the diagram clockwise so that the isobars are essentially horizontal with pressure decreasing upward. Okay. The pseudo adiabates are appreciably curved. This one. Yes. Appreciably curved. But the saturation mixing ratio lines are nearly straight on the diphigram. Okay. Saturation mixing ratio line. The angle between the isotherms and the adiabates is exactly 90. Okay. As I say, this angle is almost double of that in the imagram. And it is the greatest advantage of the diphigram. Okay. It comes very close to satisfying all the three criteria perfectly, and consequently it is widely used. Okay. Now you can see the diagram once again that you had seen earlier, and we have discussed, you know, in detail about different lines of diagrams already earlier, but you can just, for recalling your memory or refreshment, you can once again try to familiarize. Now, as you can see that there are various lines, some of them are visible to you, some of them may not be clearly visible to you, but try to make it bold. I've just tried to make it bold. So for example, these lines are isobars. Okay, this type of lines are isobars. Okay, these type of lines are isotherms. As you can see dimly on the y-axis, 1.5, 2, 3, 5, 7, 10, 15, 20. Okay, they are the temperatures, and so they are slanted, okay, isotherms. And these are the dry adiabates, lines of equal potential temperature. Okay, constant potential temperature. So dry adiabat and the isotherms are perpendicular to each other, 90 degree. All right. Now this dotted line is a saturation mixing ratio line, a constant saturation mixing ratio with respect to a plane of water surface. Okay, grams per kilogram. And this is the pseudo adiabat or saturated wet adiabat, lines of constant equivalent potential temperature for saturated air parcel. Okay, so they are the different lines, isolines, a typical diffigram, which you have seen the actual diffigram we have already seen yesterday, day before yesterday, and discussed in detail. Okay. So the next thermodynamic diagram which I'll discuss is the so-called SQT log P diagram. SQT log P diagram. Now this diagram represents an attempt to modify the imagram so as to make the isotherm adiabat angle more, nearly 90 degrees. It was first suggested by Herlofson. In this case, we let B equal to minus R of log P. That means your x-axis is minus R of log P. So this coordinate is identical with one coordinate of the imagram. Then equation 1 that you have seen earlier becomes LA by del alpha at constant log P equal to minus 1 by R times del P divided by del of log P at constant alpha. Okay. Or we can write del A by del alpha at constant log P is equal to minus P by R. Okay. When we multiply d alpha and integrate holding log P and therefore P constant, now in this equation we can get A is equal to minus P alpha by R plus F of function of log P. So now this is your y axis. This is your y axis. Okay. And instead of having function of temperature, now you have got function of log P now compared to the imagram here. Or you can write A is equal to minus T, because from the equation of a state, you can write P alpha by R equal to T plus function of log P. Okay. So we shall choose the arbitrary function, this one, to be function of log P equal to minus K of log P. Okay, minus K of log P. So K is a constant which can we can choose. So we are not concerned with the sign of the of an area, since it only involves the direction which the cycle is carried out, as the coordinates may be written as so the coordinates may be written as, in case of SQT log P diagram, A is equal to P plus K log P and B is equal to minus R of log P. That means your y axis is T, temperature, plus K of log P, and x axis is minus R of log P in the SQT log P diagram. On this diagram, an isotherm has the equation A equal to constant plus K of log P. Okay. Or A is equal to constant minus K by R of B, or B is equal to minus R by K of A plus constant. Okay. On the STB, on the SQT log P diagram. The isotherms are straight parallel lines whose slope depends upon the value of K selected. K can be chosen to make the isotherm adiabat angle close to 90 degrees. Equation of dry adiabat is obtained as before by taking the logarithm of Poisson's equation while holding theta to be constant. For that, we can write log of P is equal to R by Cp log of P plus constant. Okay. And this is what is shown here in the diagram. This is the SQT log P diagram. This is the SQT log P diagram. Okay. All of them look similar. Just 1 minute. हेलो हाँ जी आई एम इन ए क्लास राइट नाउ कैन यू डिस्कस मी आफ्टर हाफ एन आवर Okay. Okay. All right. So the quantity R log P, okay, R log P is one of the coordinates, but log T is not. Therefore, the adiabates are not straight. Adiabates, that means these are your adiabates, your theta, okay, equal potential temperature line. They are not exact, I mean, they are not straight, but slightly curved, okay, gently curved. The adiabates are visible, but gently curved lines running from lower to lower right to the upper left, lower right to the upper left. The constant K is so chosen that the isotherm adiabate angle is 90 degree. Okay, this is what one of the criteria. So the SQT log P diagram has one, area proportional to energy. Okay, two, three sets of exactly or closely straight lines, one set of gently curved lines, and one set of markedly curved lines, which is actually this one. Most of the diagrams, as you recall, the pseudo adiabates are markedly curved, whether it is a DPI gram, whether it is a MA gram, or whether it is a SQT log P diagram. Okay. Third, an isotherm adiabate angle which varies with position on the diagram, but is approximately 90 degree. Okay. So all the three criteria of the thermodynamic diagrams are again fulfilled here also in the SQT log P diagram. Okay. So like the T5 gram, it is a good thermodynamic diagram. Okay. The last one we shall discuss is the STUV diagram. STUV diagram. Now it is not an equal area transformation of the alpha V diagram. Thus, area is not strictly proportional to energy in this case. And this is how the STUV diagram looks like. And if you recall, we have seen this diagram earlier in one of the slides. It is a diagram with a plot of temperature on a linear scale as a seesaw. Okay. And P to the power K, that means P to the power kappa R by Cp on the y-axis as the ordinate with pressure increasing downwards. Okay. In order to simplify the diagram, only one line or so for serial adiabatic process and one saturation mixing ratio line are shown here. Okay. This is the serial adiabatic process and this is our the mixing ratio. Okay. And as you can recall, as now you have seen it earlier, most of this, all of these dry adiabates, equal potential temperature, they all originate at P is equal to 0 and T is equal to 0. Okay. The greatest advantage of this diagram is that the family of lines representing dry adiabatic processes are straight lines of varying slope passing through the point T is equal to 0 degree Kelvin and P is equal to 0. Okay. This is the kind of one of the identification of the STUV diagram that all the dry adiabates or lines of equal potential temperature, they originate from the same point where the pressure and temperature are zero. The adiabate isotherm angle is nearly 45 degrees because this is your isotherm and these are your adiabates. So this angle is approximately, you can say, 45 degrees. This is one of the early thermodynamic diagrams and not a good one compared to others. Okay, STUV diagram is one of the earliest one. So, I think with this we have completed the different types of thermodynamic diagrams. Okay, but we shall come back to this thermodynamic diagrams again and again later on, you know, for different analytical purposes, because as I said, you know, thermodynamic diagrams are very, very useful for analyzing or diagnosing the properties of the atmosphere. As I said now, the observations we collect from the radio sound, now the particle profiles of temperature, specific humidity, wind, etc., etc., they all plot on the thermodynamic diagrams to analyze different characteristics to find out where is the cloud base, where is the cloud top, how much is the energy, latent energy hidden in the diagram, whether the atmosphere is stable or unstable or neutral and so on. So many things. Okay. So we have completed this thermodynamic diagrams today. Any question in today's talk? Are you all able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. So, is there any question for today? No?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. Or you will get questions when you read. When you read the book, then you will get questions. Maybe. So, I stop sharing the PowerPoint now. Stop sharing the screen. Okay. And I see that 12 students are there. So, still, so many students are still there. Okay. So, if there is no more question, is there anybody left whom I did not call in the beginning for attendance? Today, what happened to Sri Lakshmi? I think Sri Lakshmi is not present today. Anjali, any information about her?
I don't know, sir.
You don't know? Okay. So, Sri Lakshmi is absent today and some more also. Okay. So, all right. If there is no question, it's already almost 1:33, 1:34. So, we stop today and then we will meet on Monday, right? Monday, okay, Monday, yeah. Monday, there are so many activities going on. But we'll meet on Monday. We'll have class on Monday. Okay. So, all right then, we stop the class for today.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.